Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Lion's Den Show. And here's your host, Cody, Robert, Judy.
Hello and welcome to the Lion's Den Show. I'm your host and your coach, Cody, Robert, Judy. Today is December 18th, 2010, and I've got three letters or papers that I want to share with you, if I can, very quickly. I first want to read a letter that was written to the United States Supreme Court justices, December 28, 2008. And it was written to all the U.S. Supreme Court justices, Justice John Stevens, Justice Antonio Scalia, Justice Anthony Kennedy, Justice David Souter, Justice Clarence Thomas, Justice Ruth Ginsburg, Justice Stephen Breyer, Justice Samuel Alito, Justice John Roberts. And I think it's very important that the people, we the people of the United States, know exactly the information that the United States Supreme Court is well aware of. That we can also assure them that we the people stand for our United States Constitution. Anyway, this letter was written December 28, 2008 by myself. I'll just give you a little picture of it. Dear Justice Scalia and the United States Supreme Court Justices, thank you for the service to the U.S. Supreme Court. The court just before God, as I see. No greater service can be rendered upon the people of the United States than preserve principles of the United States Constitution. Why, it seems to many I know our U.S. constitutional rights are diminishing with the stroke of a pen. The moral persuasions of our United States Constitutions echo as voices from the dust of the past and cries from those yet unborn, for the fabric of freedom and liberty to be mended and stitched up from the assaults of the unwise who lack understanding of the importance of the United States Constitution. For we, the people, care and love every word and every line and decry the outrageous assaults upon the decorum of so noble an outline given in the qualifications of the President of the United States, held within our U.S. Constitution and entrusted by this court, for which qualifications we do honor our President to be, as said, a natural-born citizen and 35 years of age for purposes as supposed of protection and defense in wise counsels, to the protection and defense born in these United States of America and therein receiving the spirit of protection for the motherland from that spirit which quickens the body and from which the body is dead without that spirit. So too from whence that spirit originates shall be called home, from the deepest energies of the soul and thus also the deepest yearnings to defend that are natural to the person. This is the articulation and the importance of the natural born qualification. For a fool's errand is to deny this claim and his argument unnatural in the course of the existence of life. That these natural born tendencies exist and are true, and so were faithfully included in the drafts as the keystone of our nation, known as the United States Constitution. Thus I, as one, and for others I also know, of we the people, humbly pray for this court's greatest consideration in observance to our nation's Constitution, in the proper vetting of President-elect Obama, circulated in this court as Berg versus Obama, case number 08-570, including my personal represented motion for leave and brief of amicus curiae, and articulated in the sacrifices of many in petitions to the court all over this nation, costing us our lives in time, talents, and fortunes. And that humbly after those many who have died in service to our nation. Let them be remembered. Let the spirit be maintained in the house our framers so wonderfully built. And that to ensure the preservation of freedom and liberty, to which we owe our economic success, spirited ingenuity, and accelerated maturity as a nation ruthless under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all, or be damned with the failure for our forgetfulness. To this end, I remind the U.S. Supreme Court of their sworn oath to defend the United States Constitution. I am a patriot of the United States of America, and yours humbly, Cody, Robert, Judy, signed this 28th day of December 2008. That's a letter that I wrote to the U.S. Supreme Court back then. Now, the next thing I want to show you is you remember I sued John McCain because he wasn't a natural-born citizen also. He was born in Panama, and the Congress actually adopted or enacted a law the year after his birth that included the Panama Canal Zone, which wasn't the case while he was born. Therefore, he was not a natural-born citizen. And this is order on the motions on a case that was Judy versus McCain in the District of Nevada. And this was the motion that I put in was denied by Judge Kent J. Dawson on January 7th, 2009. And what he said in that order, here's the order. Is that therefore the court denies plaintiff's motion to reopen the case. Furthermore, even if plaintiff had grounds for reconsideration, the court would deny the motion because the issue raised by his complaint are moot. Now, what he's saying there is every single Republican that voted for John McCain and voted in voting for John McCain for a non-natural born citizen, that their citizenship, their right to vote in the United States for a qualified candidate is moot. It's no big deal. And how many votes did John McCain receive in the 2008 presidential election? I mean, the popularity vote was like 49%. Now, I really just want to ask everyone out there, all the Republicans, how do you feel about a federal judge telling you, 49% of America, that your vote was cast and just thrown in the wastebasket because you weren't able to cast your vote for a natural born citizen who was qualified? How does that make you feel? I mean, it ought to make you damn mad. I don't know what in the world is wrong with these elephants. The last letter I want to show you is that I have done my part in contacting my United States representatives and receiving responses from them. This is a letter from Orrin Hatch in response to one of my letters that I sent to him. He says, "Dear Mr. Judy, thank you for your letter expressing your concern about the eligibility of President Barack Obama for the presidency of the United States." I can't even stand to see that name president associated with Barack Hussein Obama, who's the biggest fraud this nation has ever seen. I am aware of a number of rumors and allegations primarily circulating via the internet. By God, do your homework! I certainly understand your concern regarding this issue. Indeed, I have the utmost respect and reverence for our nation's constitutional values, and as your senator, I have made the preservation of these values my highest priority. What a bunch of horse buckies. I'm always wary of any effort to undermine the intent of those who drafted the Constitution. Oh, really? However, while there are some potential complicated laws regarding U.S. citizenship, the facts are pretty simple. We're not talking about U.S. citizenship, Mr. Senator Orrin Hatch. We're talking about a natural-born citizen in which our president has to be in order to be the president of the United States. We're not talking about U.S. citizenship laws. There's only one position articulated in our Constitution that demands a natural-born citizen, and that is the office of the president. You can be a senator, you can be a congressman, and you do not have to be a natural-born citizen. But to our president, you're damn right, he has to be a natural-born citizen. So, as he continues further, the facts are pretty simple with regard to President Obama. Yes, they are very simple. The first section of the 14th Amendment of the Constitution reads as follows: "All persons born or naturalized in the United States and subject to the jurisdiction thereof are citizens of the United States." That's true. They are citizens, but they are not natural-born citizens, Mr. Senator Orrin Hatch. Do you know what a natural-born senator, do you know what a natural-born citizen is? And of the state wherein they reside. That is not a natural-born citizen. President Obama was born in Hawaii. No, he was not. Will you ask him for a long-form birth certificate? He's never shown one. And the one on the internet that you reference to is a fraud. You can see it's a fraud. My God, why don't you care? President Obama was born in Hawaii, making him a natural-born citizen. Why do you think to be a senator or a congressman, the natural-born citizen quotation was not used also, and it was only used in the case of a president in our Constitution, regardless of the status of either of his parents? That is bull. During the election campaign, he produced a certified copy of the birth certificate, which is not an official certificate from the state of Hawaii that's even acceptable. He produced a certified copy of his birth certificate. Well, it's not a long-form birth certificate. There's no doctor. There's no hospital that even claims him. Come on. Come on. And made available for examination. No, it was not. Why don't you go up and ask him, Congress? Ask him. Hold a hearing. Hold a hearing. And satisfy millions of Americans right now who are demanding that our president be a natural-born citizen, at least be qualified. While some have claimed that the document is a forgery, oh, you do know that some have claimed it's a forgery. Forgery. Hawaii state officials have publicly verified that copy is authentic. The copy is authentic. The certificate of live birth. That's not a long-form birth certificate. Hawaii can't even use it, but they do acknowledge that they ship one out to anybody that asks. And that the state health department holds the original. Oh, really? The state health department. Well, do you think that the state health department in Hawaii overrules millions of people who do not believe that Barack Hussein Obama is qualified to be president? The Hawaii State Health Department holds we the people hostage? Is that right, Congress? The Hawaii State Department of Health overrides Congress? Do you know what a natural-born citizen is, Mr. Senator Orrin Hatch? Someone who was born in America and to two American or U.S. citizens. That's what makes a natural-born citizen. That's why there is only one position in our Constitution that demands and demanded a natural-born citizen. Because natural-born citizen and U.S. citizen are two different things. And it was only exerted upon our president. At this point, I see no valid reason to doubt the authenticity of birth certificate or the president's status as a natural-born citizen. Thank you once again for your letter. Sincerely, Orrin Hatch, United States Senator. And this was dated February 4, 2009. He's a Republican. He's a Republican who no doubt voted for John McCain, who was not born in the United States. So, Republicans, how do you feel about that? Senator Orrin Hatch, very respected man. He's actually run for president. Uses Barack Obama's fake Hawaiian certificate of live birth as an explanation of him being a natural-born citizen. Well, what excuse does he have for John Sidney McCain, who was not born in the United States, who was not covered by law, who was naturalized? Don't you understand that when you're naturalized, you were not a natural-born citizen? Why did you vote for Senate Resolution 511? I'm a natural-born citizen, and I don't need a Senate resolution claiming that I'm a natural-born citizen. Come on. Let's get our facts straight here.